Deja, would you be interested in putting in a little bit of commentary, if you want to? I am about to do the Dead Living Zombies DLC for Far Cry 5. It's literally a zombies mini storyline for Far Cry 5. Oh wait, we could play it. It's a co-op if we want to. Do you want to? Nah, never mind. I forgot that it was also an online-only thing. Well, let's go ahead and begin. Kirk wishes he could be in this. Too bad he was busy co-starring in Lost on Mars. Do-do-do-do-do. Here we go.
Oh, hey, I got a script for you. This thing is grade A pure gold. It's like Return of the Living Dead meets Bridges of Madison County. Only better. Close your eyes. Picture this. A top secret military aircraft carrying top secret cargo fucking explodes in midair after an engine malfunction. The debris rains down over a secluded wheat farm in the middle of nowhere. What's this top secret cargo, you asked? Dead soldiers that have been reanimated into zombie super soldiers. The echoing explosion wakes up the missus, and she's like, I'll check it out. But that's a bad idea because our super soldier zombies are ready for war. Ah, that zombie's in my fucking bell. This farmer is now the last line of defense to prevent a global zombie outbreak.
Guy Marvel presents Fields of Terror.
It's the middle America. Zombies on the doorstep. Our farmer's got like mysterious containers to shoot up. Let's call them mutation stations. Just walk nuts. And taken clear. The lens flares will look much better. Yeah, but I love it. Your cinematic signature is gonna be all over this. And these mutation stations are glass capsules. Filled with zombie making goo. I can just imagine our hero fussing open that glass with some bullets. Ah, it's so fucking badass.
Don't die.
Where are you going? I wish I could switch it around for a bit, but I've started a recording session. Okay, okay. Down. There's gotta be a better weapon around here somewhere.
Our hero gets to the shed and has to deal with more zombies. We need a set piece here. It's not a shed, it's where they store gas. Yeah, that is the kind of mainstreamness that this idea needs.
There's another one down. Wait a minute. Why the heck not? Perfect transportation. There we go.
In the woods, the mysterious coup is making dead dogs come back to life.
No, audiences will not like the idea of dead dogs.
Did I say dead dogs? I mean like zombie wolves.
Come on. Oh, I'm seriously sitting low on ammo. Ooh. Ammo stash. Ow! Why you... Did. Oh, I missed one. And now it's done.
You get a zombie! You get a zombie! You get a zombie! Everybody get zombies!
I was about to say, I'm pretty sure they're supposed to be moving. Did that do it? Yes.
It's not extraterrestrial.
Yeah, so I know if you did similar stuff in that TV show, but imagine it was done better.
I want awards for that show.
And you lost the bunch.
You know what? I'm gonna pass. The idea was pretty basic. I'm only responsible for this act.
Come on!
Ha. I suppose it is. Okay. First one wasn't too bad. Let's try this one. I already see it's already more... just more zombies. I'll say zombies are pretty cool, but this guy has like an obsession with zombie-based stuff. It's like, take a jail pill. Ten out of ten voice acting.
When the bullets run dry and mission annihilation turns into mission survival, I say shit.
Only way we're gonna live is by surviving.
A war where the enemy's already dead. Who's not interested? Our hero has to get to the ammo drop, or else they die and become the enemy.
I like how Spec Ops teams just randomly have a baseball bat. I think that needs to be rewritten. Check the script. How the heck?
So our hero goes by the corpse of a squad mate. Next one is a sweet ass weapon.
You're focusing on the weapon and not the fallen comrade?
Oh, our hero knew this guy would be the first to go.
So where the heck do I go then? Okay, I passed up the area. No wonder.
Instead of dealing with it, they're avoiding it.
Okay.
Okay, so then there's a flip
Wait a minute. It's right at the fucking flip gas tanker. The explosion will make people shit themselves.
Come on.
The hero finds themselves with literally nowhere to go. Literally. Maybe we can hear the hero's inner monologue. There's despair, loss. Or they can just use a cool grappling hook.
Yeah. Don't invest in this. Like you just said, you would end up, your career would be taking a big dip. Oh, I missed another doorway, didn't I? Did I? Oh, no way. I think I know. First. Just gotta casually mow down whatever undead stands in the way. Okay. Well, that's movie producers for you. Damn, nothing but a dang shotgun. Is there a stash around here? Oh, there we go. Found what I was looking for.
The main character gets to the ammo truck, and there's a new gun. One more character. Zombie Sasquatch character! Whoa! Plot twist! Ah, in your bite your face, zombie!
Holy crap. Ow! Holy crap! You know what? I'm taking this. Oh crap. Crap, just run. Holy crap. Well, nothing's more interesting than fighting a zombie Sasquatch. Dead, finally dead, double check. Yeah, that just magically appeared.
What's that?
More zombies.
All right. Holy crap.
No.
Maybe if I can get through the endless horde of zombies first. They just infinite? Okay. Okay, I cannot turn around anymore. You know what? Just run. How about you leave now and I won't press charges? That didn't take as long as I thought it would. Anyways, let's move on. Undying love. A love story amidst a zombie apocalypse. Because that'll surely happen. Zombies. Again, best voice acting of all time.
So, Juliet has to fight her way through the graveyard.
Because Romeo is being buried alive by his own gang.
I got it. The whole thing is going to be set in this big, spooky-ass graveyard.
These supernatural love stories always seem so silly to me.
Yeah, still last year that looked
This thing has brain-thirsty zombies trying to eat Juliet.
So basically an action movie love story.
To be honest, this isn't half bad of a pitch, but it could use a bigger storyline.
That's all I'm going to say. Needs a bigger storyline. Oh, I got a shovel this time.
So, the graveyard's like a perfect place for my Hitchcock-style cameo. It'll be a statue. That's an expensive cameo. How can you put a price on art?
Yeah, cameos are expensive. This guy clearly does not get budget. And for our next scene, we're going to break the fourth wall and talk about budget cuts. Ah, I see through here. At this point, the guy would have already been buried. Okay. I really need a stash. The stash of ammo, stash of weapons, something. Kinda could need it right about now. I mean, this idea, I probably would pay for. I mean, if it was pretty decent. But this guy, he's just making up stuff as he goes. We need a real director on it. Didn't even know I had a pistol. Gotta say, it's a pretty decent pistol. I'll give it that. At this point, the mutation stations are becoming kind of cliche. Thank you. Ah, crap. Okay, this is definitely not easy. Alright, crap. Okay, that hurts. Hey, come on. Yeah, I'm running on a fine line of ammo right now. Okay, and oh, there we go.
Juliet sees a sentimental grenade launcher.
That's sentimental?
Yeah, for this situation, it kind of is. And also, you know what this guy is pitching. Come on. Boom.
The only thing standing between the lovers is a church.
Let me guess. Juliet has to climb over it using her superpowers.
Nice idea, but I want it to be more grounded in reality. There'd be scaffolding all around the church.
And, of course, scaffolding is just randomly open. Totally realistic. So I have to jump that. Okay, let's give it a shot. Crap. Wait, never mind, I just figured out what I was doing. There we go. Okay.
And then Juliet sees her lover's coffin, and the gang try to bury him.
Let me guess. She has to kill them all.
Exactly! We are totally on the same wavelength, but man! And then the gang member's like, I'm gonna kill the hero!
Hey. Just gotta double check. There's the last guy. And that's how you finish them off. Anyways. no, you aren't. What's the next pitch? Escape from the rooftop. Let's see. Let's see what this beholds. You might want to avoid scrolling through all these so-called tips in case you spoil something. Yeah, whatever. Okay. What's the guy's big plan this time?
One movie. Picture this. It's the year 28. The world as we know it has been completely overrun by the living dead. Civilization has taken to the sky.
I like how this guy is just harassing every single movie producer in existence.
Find themselves amidst a new war, one between the militia, our good guys, and the vulturers. A street gang. Like a rooftop gang, vying for control of the new world. Sky world. Tensions have risen between the two factions. The body counts have doubled, which Joey serves to beat, and strengthen the zombie population. The only way to ensure a future is through peace. Let the two sides come to an agreement. When zombies attack!
Question is, which faction am I in?
Our hero is the last man standing.
I like the setup. This can be an allegory.
Wow, it's gonna be allegory, all right. So, our hero's gonna fight off like a million zombies.
A million? While the chopper's swinging back around.
What the? I literally have to kill that many zombies. Why is that a thing? No! I didn't sign up for this. Ooh, I got a pipe this time. Double kill.
So far, I feel this lacks the courage to say anything about any real problems.
The real problem I'm addressing is entertainment. Think about it.
I'll say a lot of movies do have a lack of good entertainment, but this is a little tedious, if you ask me. Okay, you gotta be kidding me right now. Is there anything else that's actually laying around? Seems a little ridiculous that I've only got two weapons and they're barely helping me up against these things. Oh, crap. Nothing like queuing the C4. Come on. There we go. Got a fast reload speed too. Oh, come on.
If I'm picturing it correctly, it's just carnage. What are you trying to say here? You have a message?
Yeah, my message is, hey audience, thanks for the catch. Look at this cool shit and forget about your worthless life for 2 hours.
All right, that's enough zombies. What's next?
What's next? A fucking high-powered machine gun?
Maybe you can say something about guns.
I am. I'm gonna say no other movie has ever made shooting up zombies look this fucking cool.
I'm surprised this person is even going with the zombie idea. Doesn't seem like she would really be a zombie person, but people got their own taste.
Let's fucking spice this shit up!
Of course, explosive barrels appear out of nowhere.
Walking Dead come in! Ah, fuck, I mean, I can't say that because of copyright. Fucking
fucking lawyers can't let you do anything these days.
I mean, actually, you could have made a reference. I mean, you kind of just did. But that's how some companies be like. You mention them even once and they're like, "You're trying to steal my stuff!"
After the machine gun, the chopper lands.
No, not yet. I can't warn! The radar's picking up something head in your way! And then, just when we think things can't get any...
I got a random flamethrower now. Can you explain where I got the flamethrower? What? These are Wolverines, not werewolves. Idiot.
Right?
Oh shit. You got more hostiles inbound!
No, like seriously. More.
It's the Vulturists, our rooftop gang. I mean, since there's no zombies around, they blame our hero for the massacre. He killed their people. Waste that. Kill the chosen one!
I'm sorry, what now?
See, our hero is the chosen one. And that's gonna pay off on like a 6 spin-off slash sequel. The Age of the Chosen Ones. Civil War, Part 1.
Taste grenade launcher. There we go.
And our hero hops on and flies off to the sequel.
You're ending this on a sequel?
There is more. The Die Marvel Cinematic Universe is like 50, 60 years worth of movies. Easy. I got outlines.
I'll pass. At this point in my career, I want to do something with more substance.
Come on! You're telling me that cool isn't the substance.
I'm telling you to start swinging.
Ha! Killer climate. Press circle to crouch and pretend that you can hide from the zombies. Who's Guy Marvel harassing now?
I'm Guy Marvel. And first off, it is an honor to be pitching to an award-winning visionary director.
You're not gonna know anybody with an idea.
Picture this. It's a national park. It's peaceful, it's serene, and it's like a typical normal day. We follow a good old American family.
The hero should be a park ranger.
But it's about a
climate.
Okay, this one just doesn't sound like a good pitch at all.
Okay, so we start in the park ranger's tower.
I had a better idea. What if the main character was the owner of a bar? See, zombies consume the life essence of the living, but they don't live themselves. I've seen a place where they can relax.
They're zombies. I think you're giving them a bit more brain function than they actually have.
Even the smallest creature with the smallest brain can appreciate art.
WT fuck, dude! This is a zombie movie about the environment. Can I just walk you through my idea?
Nobody really owns ideas. Fine. On with it.
Okay, so we're this park ranger, and we come down from our tower.
You said something interesting there. The park ranger had to come down from his tower. Have you ever read my manifesto?
I bought it, but look, I haven't finished it yet. Been busy, you know.
Well, nothing like starting the journey off with killing some wildlife. Okay. Wolves, moose.
So, our hero takes the shortcut to the cabin.
Wolverine.
Of course. The good old American way. Take a shortcut.
This way ain't easy. There's some awesome climbing. And then our hero sees the toxic goop seeping through the rocks and...
Love the visual. It's so pedestrian. It's what I'd expect an art student to come up with.
To be honest, I like the idea. I like the scenery of that.
In the park, there's this cool zipline thing.
Only in America would things like this be fun. They are ridiculous and stupid.
Look, they just forget I said anything.
Run! Oh, hello. Oh, this has explosive rounds. Nice. Guess we'll go the only way we can really go. Okay, I was thinking that wolf was probably just going to attack.
Cross paths with a zombie bear.
I'm not surprised. What is it supposed to be a surprise?
Okay, come on. Stay dead. I will say, I like the design for the zombie animals.
I think this story would be better told at night.
No! Man, it's gotta be during the day. The audience has to actually see the environment. This whole movie is a message on the environment.
But the darkness at night is more ominous.
I want it to be set during the day.
Night.
Day!
Night!
Oh, crap.
I just have to put my foot down. This whole movie takes place over the course of one day. Got it? That is it!
Fine.
That'll make shit interesting.
Here it is. Near the house, the ranger sees the source of the problem.
It is the toxic goo. It's infected the fresh water and created zombies!
I like what you do so far. No, I'm not really seeing the whole goofy. I think if you crop out all of you, this idea and merge it with the ideas in my artistic manifesto. Maybe even show my book. What?
Whatever, man. Fine.
Holy crap. The book was literally just knocked off of his pedestal. Okie dokie. I will say it. The infectious liquid spilling into the ground was kind of, was pretty good, but...
Remember that family in the chat? Well, they're dead. I thought we got that plot line.
Be honest, Guy Marvel has some good ideas, but his way of directing it is garbage. If he actually knew how to direct these, then it would be good. Oh, what was that? Ooh, hello. Definitely take that.
I'm done. We're done. I think there's more we can do with the ending. What ending are you envisioning? Whatever.
So you're not envisioning an ending.
Now in the film, it's not.
Ah, why?
It's foreshadowing impending doom.
You want doom? How about adding a fucking blood dragon here to fuck them the fuck up?
Well, we're getting a reference to Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon.
We put some fucking firepower there.
They're blind. They're supposed to be blind. You programmed it wrong. Blood dragons are supposed to be blind. Why would you not go by how they are in Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon?
Right here.